Good day, students. In this video, we are going to discuss some important points related to analog to digital converter and digital to analog converter interfacing with 8051. And this is the chip we are going to use, PCF8591. It is a 16-pin IC which includes both ADC and DAC sections. And this configuration is available in your manual. So here, when the chip accesses a ADC, we need to give analog input, and if it accesses a digital to analog converter, we need to give a digital signal and we get an output of analog signal. If you are using this particular chip as a ADC, we need to give analog input. The analog input can be given via this A in. There are 4 channels available. We can use any one of them. If we are going to use this as a DAC, then we need to give digital signal. So from where we need to give the digital signal? So this particular chip will be interfaced to our 8051 through this port. So here PC is mentioned, which is actually equivalent to port 2. So 2 pins of port 2 will be used, and the communication between this PCF8591 and 8051 will be a I2C communication, just as we did in 7 segment LED interfacing. So whatever digital data we want to convert, we have to use these 2 pins, SCL and SDA, for sending the data. And if you send some digital data through this SDA pin, it will be converted into analog inside this chip, and the analog output will be available in this pin. So DAC output we can take from this pin. If you are using it as a ADC, we need to provide analog input, and the digital converted output will be transmitted via this SDA line to the microcontroller. So here, the input for the analog signal can be given externally or from the internal input. This is decided by the jumper 1. So if this EAN is connected, then it is an external input. If this PA6 is connected, then it is an internal input. In our experiment, we are going to connect an internal input which can be given by a pot resistor that is connected in the kit. And the output for DAC is an analog signal which we can see through CRO or DSO. And this signal will be available in the pin P12, and this is the DAC output and this is the ground. So CRO should be connected between this DAC 0 and ground to see the analog output. So these are the basics of ADC and DAC section. And when coming to the program of DAC, so we are going to convert the digital to analog. So it is a very easiest program. We can generate our own digital data, and if you feed that digital data into this chip through this SDA line, the chip will convert it to analog, and it is available in this line, which we can connect a CRO and we can see the signal. For example, writing a program is very easy for a DAC section. So before seeing that program, let us see the operation of the chip. So this PCF8591 is a ADC bar DAC chip, and this is a block diagram of that particular chip. So here, I hope by this time you will be knowing about how a ADC and DAC works. It is a successive approximation technique where we will be given the V reference and ground, and according to the V reference, it will be converted. So 4 inputs we can given to the multiplexer, and at a time 1 input will be sent through this DAC, and this analog input will be converted into digital output, and it is stored in the data registers. So here if you see, if you want to convert a digital data to analog, the digital data is sent through this SDA line, and after the collection of all the 8 bit, then it is collected in the DAC register, which fed to the successive approximation register and converted into an analog output, and it is obtained here. If you are giving an analog input, this will be converted to a digital signal and it is stored in the ADC data register. I think you can understand between these registers. So when the chip is used as a DAC, this register is used to input the digital. When the chip is used as a ADC, this register is used to get the converted digital output. All the digital data is related to the or sent to the microcontroller through this pin. And A0, A1, A2 decides the address of this particular PCF8591 which is connected to the microcontroller. So this is the block diagram of that particular chip. With this basic information, if we again see that particular chip, here we can see how we are connecting the address pins. In address pins, A0 is connected to ground and A1, A2 are connected to VCC. This is going to formulate your address. And let us see how we are going to formulate that address. So here, while using this DAC and ADA section, you need to understand two things. One is control byte and another one is address byte. First, we have to select the device. For that, we require the address bytes. So, address bytes is given by this format. In this format, the slave address is 1001 A2A10 read write. So 1001 is fixed, so MSB of the address is always 9. And according to the A2A1A0 connection, and whether we are going to read or write, we are going to decide. So for D2A conversion, we will be writing, and ADC conversion, we are reading. Accordingly, we need to fix the last bit. So this formulates the slave address. While we formulate the slave address, after that we need to give the control. So control byte specifies out of 4 channel which channel we are going to use and whether we are going to use a separate channel or some differential channels. So like that we can formulate. In our example, we are going to use a simple signal and we are going to use only one channel and as a separate input. So accordingly, we will be configuring this mode. So the control byte is provided, and if it is the chip is used as a DAC, the only thing we need to do this analog output enable flag. It should be 1 if you want analog output from DAC. So the same control byte, while using it as a ADC, we need to formulate all these bits accordingly, and if you are using it as a DAC, we should be concentrating in this particular bit. So accordingly, we have to formulate the address and control bit. After forming this, we should write our program. So example program for DAC. So I want to generate some triangular waveform in CRO. How it is possible? So here if you see the triangular waveform, this might be some signal. So if I am starting from some 00 to FF, if I send 00, this point will be the analog. Suppose if you think it is a 0 to 5 volts converter, 00 implies 0 volts and FF implies 5 volts approximately. So if you send 00, this point is valid. If you start increasing the 00 up to FF, you will be getting the positive ramp signal like this. So I am generating a for loop where I am assigning I as 0 and I am incrementing the I up to FF. And I am sending that data through I square C to that particular chip. in which this digital signal is converted to analog, and that analog value is seen in this CRO or DSO. And similarly, after this for loop, I am writing another for loop where I am decrementing the value from FF so that I can get the negative RAM. So the value starts from FF and goes on decreasing and ends in 0. When these two for loops is called with the while high loop, the endless triangular waveform is produced in the CRO. So this is a simple program to generate the triangular waveform through I2C domain. Hope you understand how this particular DAC program is working. So similarly, if you coming to the ADC program, what we need is, in DAC program, we are converting the digital data which we generates inside the program, and we are transmitting the data to the DAC where that digital data is converted to analog, and the data and the value of analog signal is seen in CRO. In the reverse thing, if you are using the chip as a ADC, we need to give analog input and we need to see the digital output. So analog input is given through internal clock by using a proper jumper connecting these two pins. While connecting this and executing the ADC program, this analog input is converted into digital output. And this digital output can be serially transmitted to the computer itself, and we can see the output through the computer. Let us see how this output can be seen. To see the serially transmitted output from the microcontroller to the computer, we need to use another software which is called WinXTalk. To use WinXTalk, first search the program and start the program. So WinXTalk will be open. Here we need to select the communication port. This port should be equal to the port in which Flash Magic is set. After setting, you need to open the reception window where we can see the digital values transmitted from the computer. So using this particular software is very simple. Here you need to open the software and you need to open the reception port and set the same port so that we can see the converted digital value there. So while writing the program, we need to initialize this transmitter section, which includes loading of the suitable TCON, SCON, TMOD values. So we are going to serially transmit the converted digital data to the computer. So for that, we are setting the timer 1 in auto reload mode, and we are using the 8-bit UART mode for serial transmission. So thus we are initializing the UART, and we are initializing the I2C to get the converted analog value to the digital, and the more description of the program will be given in the face-to-face classroom. What you need to do understand is, the same chip is used for both purposes, ADC as well as DAC. To use at a ADC, what should be the address and what should be the control. And to use as a DAC, we should know what should be the address and what should be the control. And how the input analog should be given, and how the input digital to be given, and where to see the output. These are important things. When you are using DAC, you have to see the output in CRO. When you are using ADC, you are going to see the digital output in the computer through WinXTalk. So this is the major important points you need to remember. And else any other doubts, you can go through the manual. And if you get any precise doubt, you can contact me in person. Right. Thank you for listening.